Hello guys, in this tutorial you will learn how to create VRay IES lights in 3ds Max. So the first question is, why should you learn VRay IES lights? If you want to create complex light distributions like these and these, then this tutorial is for you. So without any further ado, let's get started. First, render the scene and save the result. You have three methods to create VRay IES lights. I like method 3. First, I will go to my side viewport. Currently, it's not side, it's front, but I'm looking from this angle here. Wall side, you can say. Next, click on VRay IES light icon. Click here and drag it like this. Not totally straight, little bit towards the wall. This is actually this wall. Next, click here. Go to your left or top viewport, it's up to you. I will click it here and drag it like this all the way here. Next, render the scene. Light intensity is extremely low right now. So I will turn interactive rendering. Select my light. Go to modify. And start increasing my intensity value. Plus, I will also change my color mode to temperature and take my temperature to 5000 because I like these kind of tones, warm tones. By default, VRay IES light acts like a sphere light. To get complex light distributions, you have to download free IES lights from the internet. I have put some links in the description. After downloading the files, click in the IES file slot here and browse your IES file. I am currently using this X arrow IES file. It will give me a shape like this. Now render again. If you can't see the light in the render, there can be two reasons for this. Either the light is too far from the wall, the light is not close to the wall, or the intensity is low. In my case, the light is close to the wall, but the light intensity is low. So again, select the light and increase the light intensity value. I will start interactive rendering and start increasing the light value. Now, I am happy with my light intensity and IES file shape. So the next step is clone these lights. Click here. This is my final result. Now, all you have to do is to change the IES file here and adjust the light intensity value and get these awesome results. Plus, one more thing, as I always do in all of my renders, click here, add an exposure and add a contrast of 0.1 or 0.15. I love it like this. So guys, I hope you like this tutorial. If you like it, give it a like. If you love it, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating guys. Bye bye.